move that statue. What was the story behind that?
What was the story behind that?
Yeah, Thomas Francis Meagher.
I think he was a senator or something over there in the States. He was over there anyway in the state, for the state. His name was Tooley or something from Missoula. And he was trying to get that statue of Thomas Francis Meagher out there by hook or crook, and they put a new sword on there, it'd be gone right away, you know. And there was a lad over in the Missoula station. His name was Barry Cooper, I think, and I called him Cooper, Barry Cooper was every night on the radio station talking about getting the statue of Thomas Francis Meagher out of the Capitol. Well, Jesus, I went after him with a letter. And I wrote a lot of pages in it, you know. And I told him where to look or to find out the information that I had in the letter. And from the echoes of the distant past, and it was that Tooley's grandfather was the governor over there after Thomas Francis Meagher, and he was the one that was trying to get the statue out of there, and it was the governor Tooley that had the statue. He told the delegation that went over from Butte that he'd pick this. They could pick the site out for it there and everything, give him permission. So, Jesus, he was the laughing stock of the place, I guess. But I signed it was an old-timer. And, Jesus, they said on the station, we'd like to know who the old-timer was.
Good job.
Let's see. He was arrested. There were 9 of them arrested and sent down to Tasmania. It was Van Diemen's Land that time, down south of Australia. And the Irish in this country around Pennsylvania and all back there, they raised the money for to get a ship, and they got a ship and got it all ready and sent it down. And in them days it was sailing vessels, you know, and went down and took Thomas Francis Meagher and the rest of them off of the island down there. And they all got to be big shots in different countries. And when the Queen checked on it, they found that Thomas Francis Meagher, he was the acting governor here in Montana. He had been in the fighting. He was a general in the North, for the North, you know, in the Civil War. But anyway, he was doing all right over in Hill. And Lincoln sent him up here until we had an election in Montana. That's how he come to be here. But anyway, he went on a boat down the Missouri. They used to have boats in them days. And anyway, he must have got pushed off by one of the English agents, you know. They used to follow him. They followed Wolf Tone's brother around New York City there for a long time. Government, British agents.
Do you think he might have got crossways with the vigilantes? Wilberforce Saunders and some of those people?
I don't know.
Do you think it might have been an English agent?
Oh, I think he got back. Them English agents were, didn't you know that my cousin Dan Sheehan was working for the Green Line Car Barn in New York. He was born here in Butte. And the English come up off of the ship in New York and told him he had to come down and sign in as an English sailor.
What did he tell them?
Well, he told them no way. He said, yeah, he said, I was born here.
Huh.
never did go, but it kind of shook him up, you know. But Jesus, tracking people down. He was raised in Ireland, you know, but so was my brother. My cousin Mike was raised in Ireland, his brother. They were raised in Ireland. They lived here with Mike lived here with me in Butte, and I lived with him in Ireland, back in New York.
I sure appreciate you taking the time to do this, Yank.
Well, we're going to start off with a tune called Dairy Hornpipe, and I don't know where John learned this one, but it's a nice tune. Ready?